Welcome back. In stage three of this mini project, you're going to establish the tunnels by configuring the on-premises side of the architecture, or at least part of it. The on-premises side has two layers, the IPSEC tunnels, which you'll configure in this stage of the mini project, and the BGP system, which you'll configure in the next. So let's hop over to the console and get started activating the four IPSEC tunnels that we're going to be using. That's two tunnels to each on-premises router, one of those between each router and each of the two AWS endpoints. So let's get started implementing that configuration, and to do that we're going to move to the AWS console. Now this is going to be the most complex part of this demo series. There's going to be a lot of command line work that we need to do to configure the on-premises routers to be able to establish IPSEC tunnels between the on-premises side and the AWS side. Now, a really important thing that you need to check before you implement this stage of the demo series is that both of the VPN connections are in an available state. You might have to refresh it, but make sure before you continue, both of these are showing available and in green. If not, you might need to wait a short while until that is the case, but you cannot complete the next step until both of these are in an available state. Assuming they are, we can go ahead and close down this tab, and we'll need to move to the EC2 console. So click on EC2 or type it in the Find Services box. Select Instances. Now there's going to be some configuration that we need to do on both of the on-premises routers in order to establish the IPSEC tunnels between that router and AWS. So let's start with router 1. So select router 1, right click, click connect, select session manager, and once you're able, click on the connect button. Now once you're connected, type sudo space bash and press enter. This will give you root permissions on this Linux instance, and then type cd space /home/ubuntu/demo_assets and press enter. Now don't worry, all of the commands that we use within this stage of the demo series are contained in the stage 3 instructions attached to this video. Now let's clear the screen to make it easier to see, and then do an ls space hyphen la. Now in order to make this more efficient, I've already downloaded to both of these instances some configuration files with placeholders that you just need to edit. So there's the ipsec.conf file, which contains the actual configuration for the IPSEC tunnels. There's the ipsec.secrets file, which contains the authentication information that this Linux server will use to authenticate with AWS. And then there's a script file, ipsec-vti.sh, which will actually enable and disable the IPSEC tunnels whenever the system detects traffic. So we need to edit each of these, put them in the correct place, and then restart the instance to activate these tunnels. Now in both of the videos of this stage of the mini project, you're going to be asked to edit each of these files. Within these files are a number of placeholders, and you'll notice that the name of these placeholders is the same as in the template file that you populated during the previous step. Now I do go relatively quickly in these videos when I'm doing the replacing, but you should find it fairly simple if you just take note of the name of each of the placeholders and then look for the corresponding value within the template document that you populated. It should be relatively easy to make sure that you get the correct values. So just use this video as a guide on where these placeholders are, but you should use the values in your template to quickly replace these placeholders. So let's start by editing the ipsec.conf file. We'll do that with nano space ipsec.conf and press enter. Now if we just scroll down, inside this configuration file there's the configuration for the two IPSEC tunnels. So at the top here, tunnel 1, and at the bottom, tunnel 2. Now we need to replace these placeholders with the corresponding values from the template document that you entered all of that configuration information into in the previous stage of this demo. So let's start doing that. So this is for connection 1, And this top component here is for tunnel one, so make sure you're using the correct values. Again, if you make a mistake at this point, it will affect the demo later on. So under tunnel one, next to left, leave the equal sign, and you need to paste in the router one private IP. So in all likelihood, yours will be different, but it should start with 192.168.12 and then something else. There's a small chance you might have the same, but in all likelihood, it's going to be different. So that's actually the internal network interface of this customer router. So next, we need to change the placeholder directly below it. And this is the customer outside IP address that will also be inside the template document. And this should be the public IP address of the on-premises router one. And again, yours will be different. And then next, we need to replace these placeholders with the outside IP address of the AWS side. So this will also be in the template document. And I've kept the names consistent, so these should have the same names in this document and the template document. So paste that in, and you'll be pasting in the same value directly below it. Next, we need to do the same process for connection one, tunnel two. So just scroll down, and we'll need to first replace this line with the private IP address. So that's the router one private IP address, and this will be the same as this top line for tunnel one. So some of these values are the same, some of them, though, will be different. So paste in the private IP address for router one. Directly below it, we'll need the public IP address for router one, which is listed as con1 tunnel 2 on-prem outside IP in the template document. And again, you'll notice that this will be the same as the corresponding value directly above, and that's fine. Next, we'll need to edit both of these AWS side outside IP addresses. So look in the template document for con1 tunnel 2 AWS outside IP, paste that in, and do the same for the line below. Now note that these two lines are different from the corresponding lines above. So remember that a tunnel goes from one specific customer router to one AWS endpoint. So the tunnel at the top, so tunnel one, will be going to a different AWS endpoint than the tunnel at the bottom, which is tunnel two. So for the right IP addresses, they will be different than the right IP addresses in tunnel one at the top, and that's okay. So that's everything that we need to update. Just double check that you've got those values correct, because if you haven't, it will impact the demo later on. So press Control O to save that file and Control X to exit, and then we're going to edit the second file. And this is ipsec.secrets. This time we're going to need to change a total of 6 placeholder values. So to try and keep this efficient, let's do the starting value first. So connection 1, tunnel 1, on-prem outside IP. So this is the public IP version 4 address for router 1. Copy that into your clipboard. Now this is actually going to be what we're going to replace the first value on both of these lines with. So this is going to be the on-premise outside IP for both of these lines. They're the same IP address. So you can save some time by just pasting both of those in. Next, we need the connection 1, tunnel 1, AWS outside IP address. This will be different for both of these lines, so don't paste in the same IP address by mistake. So the top line is for connection 1, tunnel 1. The bottom line is for connection 1, tunnel 2. And again, both of these are named the same in the template document. Next, we'll need the pre-shared key for connection 1, tunnel 1. So delete this placeholder. And again, make sure you do copy all of the characters for this pre-shared key. It's very easy to miss a character. I've done it many times. So just double check that value. And then do the same for the pre-shared key for connection 1, tunnel 2. Again, making sure to get all of the characters. Once you've done that, just save that file. And that's the authentication information for both of the tunnels for connection 1. The next file I need to edit is the script that brings up the IPSEC tunnels whenever required. So nano space IPSEC hyphen vti.sh. Now, there are four placeholders that we need to replace in this document. These are the inside IP addresses at the customer side and the AWS side for both of these tunnels. So delete the placeholder and replace it with the same value inside the template document. So this is connection 1, tunnel 1, on-premise, inside IP address. Paste that in and make sure that you leave the slash 30 on the end. Then we'll need to do the same for the remote side, which is the AWS side. So replace this with connection 1, tunnel 1, AWS, inside IP. And just as verification, this should be exactly the same, only one less. Then we need to do the same for tunnel 2. So get connection 1, tunnel 2, on-prem, inside IP. So just delete the placeholder. And then paste in connection 1, tunnel 2, on-prem, inside IP, making sure that you leave the slash 30 on the end. And we need to do the same for the remote side, which is the AWS side, inside IP. So this is connection 1, tunnel 2, AWS, inside IP. And as verification, that should be one value less, but otherwise exactly the same as the IP address above. Once you've done that, just verify the values. It's really important that these are correct. Press Ctrl-O to save that file and Ctrl-X to exit. Now at this point, we're going to copy all of these three IPSEC configuration files into the etc directory where they'll be read by the StrongSwan software. So do a cp space IPSEC star, so that's a wildcard indicating all of the IPSEC files, and then a space, forward slash, etc. And then one last thing that you need to do is make the script file executable. So do a chmod space plus x for executable, forward slash, etc, forward slash, IPSEC hyphen vti dot sh. And then press enter. That will make that script executable. And then to test this, we need to restart the StrongSwan software. To do that, systemctl space restart space StrongSwan, all one word, lowercase, and press enter. Now, if everything's working as it should, you can run an ifconfig and you should see two virtual tunnel interfaces, VTI1 and VTI2. And if you do, that means these tunnel interfaces are active and connected to AWS. So that's everything that we need to do for this on-premises router. Now we need to close this tab and do the same for the on-premises router too. So let's go ahead and do that. Close this tab. Now, this particular stage of the demo was getting a little bit on the long side, and so I've decided to split it into two videos. So this is the end of video one of this stage. Go ahead and complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the second video of this demo series.